The Procreate 5X update has added a snapping feature that has given us the ability to make seamless repeat patterns without the help of other apps, and that's what I'm going to show you today. I'm working on a canvas that's 10 inches by 10 inches at 300 dpi. That means it is 3,000 pixels across by 3,000 pixels down, and I've created all of the elements that I want to use in my design. It ended up being a lot of layers, so each one of these mugs has several layers each. So what I'm going to do is duplicate my canvas. So if you go back to the gallery and you just swipe and duplicate, I can leave my originals preserved and I can now flatten each one of these mug layers. To do that though, I don't want to just flatten each group. I want to do a copy and paste for each one. So what I mean by that is I'm going to turn off even the background layer and leave on one mug at a time and do three finger swipe down, copy all. Now I'm going to come up out of my group and three finger swipe down and paste. And what that's done, I'll turn off my original layer here. What that's done is it's given me my mug all on one layer. So I am going to do that really quick for all five mugs. All right, and now I have all of the originals I can delete, and that's because I do have that other canvas that has all the originals in it, and I have all my mugs on single layers, and I have a lot of layers to work with now when making my design. So I'm going to turn off a couple of mugs, and the reason I'm doing that is because I want to have some of my mugs for my initial placement and have my other mugs for later. I know that these are going to be too big, so I'm going to select those three mugs all together and just make them a little bit smaller. I'm on uniform, so they all got smaller in the right proportions. Now I want to turn on a grid here so I can see exactly where the center is. If you go to the wrench tool, canvas, turn on drawing guide, edit drawing guide, it defaults to this 2D grid, and you're going to want to max out the size of the grid. I'm going to go ahead and change the color of my grid lines and the thickness and opacity. You do not need to do that. This is just so it shows up in the video. And now I can see where the center is, horizontal and vertical. And those are important spots to know about because we're basically going to be cutting on those, and I need to place any elements that I want to have along those lines in this step. I can't add elements later to those lines. So I'm going to go ahead and place some mugs here. This is a lot of trial and error that you'll just need to play around with. The biggest thing to remember is you cannot go over the edge. So you can't let your designs go over the edge because as soon as you deselect it, it crops it. When you select it again, it's gone. So don't do that. Just undo really quick. All right, so what I've done here is I've placed quite a bit of my elements along these lines. And I only have a little bit of space here and there that don't have any elements on the line. For now, I'm going to go ahead and place a dot. So I'm going to a monoline brush. I have my own monoline brush, but any monoline brush will do. And then I'm going to pick some colors from the design and just add a dot here and there. We can erase these later. I want these dots to slightly overlap that line because, again, I won't be able to add any dots, anything at all, in those areas later. All right, so I'm happy with that. And one thing you need to think about is that you're kind of leaving a lot of space in the four corners. Those four corners are going to converge into the center, and we'll add our other mugs and any other elements later to that converged space that will create. And these are going to end up being the outer area of our design. All right, I'm just looking at my design really quick. I'm going to add a brand new layer, and I'm going to come to a really bright color that doesn't look anything like anything that we've got here. And I'm just going to put a mark in two opposing corners. And the reason I'm doing that is I want to make sure I have pixels of color going all the way to all four sides of my canvas. And the reason for that is because when we turn off the background layer and we copy this whole canvas, we want it to copy the whole entire canvas size. If we don't have pixels all the way to the edges, then it's only going to copy to the edge of where we have pixels of color on the canvas at the moment. So if these weren't here, it would only make the canvas size that big. All right, we can go ahead and turn our grid off. We don't need the lines anymore. And I'm going to group together all of the layers that we currently have just to keep things a little tidy. I'm going to three-finger swipe down and copy all. Three-finger swipe down and paste. And now we have all of that on one layer, so we can turn off the original grouping here. We can go ahead and turn the background layer back on. And you can see here I have everything on one layer. So I need four of those. You can either keep pasting, deselect, paste, deselect. You can do it that way, or you can go ahead and duplicate the layers. I always duplicate the original, which is the bottom. And that is just because if you duplicate a duplicate, the quality is slightly diminished. So now I have four. I'm going to the top one. It doesn't matter which one you go to. This is just my process. And I'm going to tap select. Now, when you have anything selected on your screen, if you tap anywhere, if you go to tap something up here, but you accidentally tap down here, you're going to nudge the whole selection one pixel in that direction. And sometimes you won't even see it happen, and it will mess up your design. It will leave gaps. So don't do that. Be very careful not to nudge anything. So when you have something selected, though, is that's when you can get to the snapping. So you tap snapping, and then you turn snapping on right here. I like to have my distance set to max, and velocity is defaulted to 5. The distance is just about like how far away it's going to be before it snaps into place, how far from other objects. All right, now we need to slide these four designs into the four corners. We're keeping them at full image size. I'm going to deselect that really quick. And I'm going to turn these other ones off just to make it easier to see. I don't normally do that, but I don't want it to be too muddied up here in the video. So you can grab anywhere on the screen. You can also grab in here. And you're going to slide to the middle. And you're going to see gold lines. And that's how you know that that outer corner is now in the middle. And that's it. Again, make sure you don't nudge. Turn on the next one, select it, and slide it. Now I'm sliding the full size image, making sure I see the gold lines. Deselect. Turn on the next one, select. Sometimes the gold lines will look blue where it's kind of overlapping the selection dotted line. But as long as you see gold here and here, and it's not blue, like this one is blue right now, then you'll be all set. And also make sure you're not decreasing the size. We're moving. Oh, and that actually decreased the size. So sometimes you end up grabbing a little too close to the blue dot. If that's a problem, just grab outside of the canvas and slide. All right, and now we have our gold lines, and I can let go, deselect. So that was essentially cutting on those center lines and repositioning those papers. Now I need to merge those four layers. I can just pinch them together. And I'm going to freehand select the orange blob and move it right off the screen. Now we have, this is the edge of our repeat, and we need to fill in the space in the middle. So now we have our two mugs. I'm going to go ahead and move them above. They can be below. All of these things can overlap as well, as long as you are following the guidelines of everything not touching the edges. On this step, you can have things overlapping. Just don't touch the edges of the canvas. And then on this next step, when we add our final elements, we also have to make sure nothing is touching the edges. I need to turn snapping off because it's really trying to control where I put my mug. And now we just place our final elements. I'm going to add another layer and some more polka dots. The polka dots can be just kind of fillers. You can do, if you're doing a plant design, you can do more plants as fillers. You know, your design elements are whatever you want them to be. Now, this is a great point to get to, but you want to check your design by looking at a 2x2. So I've gone ahead and I've grouped together everything that we currently see. So we have our original layout down here in this other group, and now we have this group. And I'm going to turn the background layer off. This is a completed repeat pattern. You can see it's repeating in all the places it needs to repeat, but you need to do two things. You need to check to make sure you don't have any gaps in the pixels, and you need to see if you like the overall look of it at a smaller scale. So I take this and I always make a 2x2 grid of this design. So I turn the background layer off and I do my three finger swipe down, copy all, three finger swipe down and paste. And now I have that on its own layer there. I'm going to turn the background back on. All right, so here's my 1x1. I'm going to hold on to that. That's going to be kind of my original. So I need 5 total. So I'm going to have this bottom one turned off. That's just going to be sitting there, even though I have all my originals down here still. And now I have these 4 designs that I'm going to shrink. So our first step, we moved full-size images to the 4 corners. This time we're shrinking each to the 4 corners. So we need to turn snapping back on. I'm going to go ahead and turn all the other layers off except the one we're working with. And with snapping on, and you grab the blue dot, it's going to snap right to the center. Turn the next layer on, shrink that, snaps right to the center, select. If you're having a hard time getting it to snap perfectly, it's most likely because you have some other layers on and the snapping tool is trying to adjust and snap to those. So make sure you have other layers off. I want to show you how you can easily check for any gaps in your design. I turn one corner off and then I sit here and I look, where is that line exactly? So up here, it's right here, so I can then turn it on and I can look and see no gaps. Over here, I'm zoomed way in and I can turn this on and off so I know exactly where to look and I don't see any gaps. So you're going to do that for the top corners as well. So if you do it down here and up here, you will have covered all your bases and checked for gaps in all 4 spots, and I don't see any gaps. Merge those 4 layers together, and now I have this 2x2 and the 1x1. So that's the way I do it. And you, of course, have the ability to change the background and save all these different versions of your design. And now you have a 4x4. I don't use this 4x4 to upload to Spoonflower, but I oftentimes will make it just to look at this much more scaled, smaller scale view and make sure I like the layout of all the elements. So that is something to play around with as well. If you like the mugs, I do have Skillshare classes on how to make these mugs and how to make the brushes that make all these designs on the mugs. But I also have a Skillshare class on making seamless repeat patterns. So if this was a little bit sped up for you, I go into much more depth and I also talk about half drop repeats. So I find this incredibly fun and I hope you do too. Enjoy.